Mercy Watson to the Rescue by Kate DiCamillo, illustrated by Chris Van Dusen. Chapter 9. Ned and Lorenzo ran toward the call for help. They went into the Watson's house. Help! Ned and Lorenzo looked up. They saw a bed hanging out of the ceiling. They saw Mr. and Mrs. Watson holding on to the bed for dear life.
We are saved, cried Mrs. Watson.
Of course we are saved, said Mr. Watson. Mercy has alerted the fire department.
She is amazing, said Mrs. Watson. She is unbelievable.
She is a porcine wonder, said Mr. Watson.
Ned and Lorenzo ran upstairs. They picked up Mr. and Mrs. Watson. The Watson's bed sighed loudly and crashed all the way through the floor.
Boom!
Mr. Watson looked at the hole where the bed used to be. I have always believed very firmly in the fire department, said Mr. Watson.
As have I, said Mrs. Watson. As have I.
From outside the Watson's house came a squeal.
Gotcha!
Shouted Eugenia. Chapter 10. Ned and Lorenzo and Mr. and Mrs. Watson all went outside. Eugenia was sitting on the ground. Her arms were wrapped around Mercy's neck. Her cheek was resting on Mercy's back. Eugenia was breathing very loudly.
This pig, she said, was on my property.
We'd prefer that you did not call her a pig, said Mrs. Watson.
We'd prefer that you call her a porcine wonder, said Mr. Watson. After all, she did save us. She's a hero.
She's a pig, said Eugenia.
She started to cry.
There, there, sister, said Baby.
She bent over and patted Eugenia on the back. Mercy yawned. She was very tired.
I guess that's it, said Ned.
Yep, said Lorenzo. Our work here is done.
Wait, said Mrs. Watson. It's almost time for breakfast.
Oink,
asked Mercy.
That's right, breakfast, said Mrs. Watson.
She kissed the top of Mercy's head. She looked up at the firemen.
Do you boys like toast?
That's the end of chapter 10. Chapter 11. In the Watson's house around the Watson's kitchen table sat Eugenia Lincoln and Baby Lincoln and Mr. Watson and Mrs. Watson and Ned and Lorenzo and Mercy, of course. She was at the head of the table in the seat of honor. And in front of her, on her favorite blue plate, was a very tall stack of hot buttered toast.
A toast to Mercy, said Mr. Watson, holding up his glass of orange juice.
A toast to our darling, our dear, said Mrs. Watson.
A toast to Mercy, said Baby.
In my opinion, said Eugenia, pigs should not be toasted. In my opinion, pigs do not belong at the kitchen table.
To our hero, said Mr. Watson,
where would we be without Mercy?
Yes, said Mrs. Watson, who would have saved us?
I can't imagine, said Ned.
Me neither, said Lorenzo.
They all clinked glasses. Mercy had one piece of toast. Chapter 12. Outside the Watson's house, the sun was rising. First the sun was red, and then it was orange. It rose higher and higher. Inside the Watson's house, Mercy was lying on the couch. She was getting ready to take a nap.
Bright, bright as a morning sun, sang Mr. and Mrs. Watson together, but brighter still as a porcine wonder.
Mercy smiled and she closed her eyes. She was asleep before Mr. and Mrs. Watson even finished the song. Here are other Mercy Watson books that are out. We just read Mercy Watson to the Rescue. There's Mercy Watson Goes for a Ride. Mercy Watson Fights Crime. Mercy Watson Princess in Disguise.